This is Pat Salber with the Doctor Weighs In, broadcasting from the Health Tech Conference of Health Tech Capital. And it's an interesting conference because they have a lot of entrepreneurs here. And we're lucky to have one of those entrepreneurs with us this afternoon, Norm Wu from iHuman Patient. So Norm, tell me, what is iHuman Patient?
So we are basically a flight simulator for students and practicing clinicians both. And what we do is we simulate through just a web browser a complete patient encounter. So soup to nuts, patient shows up at your office, you ask about their symptoms, their medical history, you do virtual physical exams.
These are avatars?
These are avatars, animated avatars. You do physical exams, you develop hypotheses on what might be going on, differential diagnoses, you order up any kind of test that you want, review the results of those tests, and confirm the diagnosis and develop a treatment plan. So it's all about perfecting the patient assessment and diagnostic reasoning competencies.
So are you doing mainly internal medicine kind of cases, or do you also do trauma and surgery and things that require technical skills?
Well, we're doing mostly the kind of cases that require real competencies, skill development, and diagnosis. So we're not very focused on things like psychomotor skills. It's really the Sherlock Holmes part of medicine. You know, what's really going on with this patient? How do I figure that out? How do I ask the right questions? What exams do I need to order? What tests do I need to order?
So Norm, tell me, who's writing these cases? Where are you getting these clinical cases from?
Well, we work with medical educators, so we ourselves develop the technology platform. We count on medical experts to develop the case scenarios that are played on our platform. So we're working now with educators at about 40 different medical schools, including, you know, Harvard and UCSF, University of Chicago. The list is quite large there. And what they do, they have two different models. One is they have share and share-like cases, we call them, basically crowdsourced cases that are they develop for their own curricula, and then they freely share those with other schools who have the rights to make derivative cases depending on their learning objectives. Then we also have third-party sponsored cases, and a lot of these schools are working on that. So the American Medical Association, which has a very big initiative to help transform medical education, is providing grant funding for the development of a lot of cases.
So the docs get paid to do the case work?
Yes, they get paid. And so we have right now about 60 part-time educators.
And what about quality control? How do you know when if I send you a case and I have symptoms and tests and blah, 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 how do you know I actually have the right diagnosis?
Well, the cases are all peer-reviewed. If it's done by a university or medical school for their own purpose, it's usually reviewed by at least one other educator. The third-party sponsored cases, including the ones sponsored by us ourselves, are all peer-reviewed and typically have three or four other educators reviewing those cases. And then we do a final QA check internally as well. We have a couple of MDs on staff.
And one quick question, how do you make money?
We provide our solution on a subscription basis to schools or practicing clinicians, provider organizations.
Well, I think that's fantastic. And I think there's a huge need, not just in the developing world, but in the U.S. as well, to bring down the price, the cost of training people. Because I think one of the problems we're having with physicians not going into newly graduated medical students not going into primary care is that they're so in debt that they don't see how they can make a living, you know, and still pay off their student loans. So I would really love to see the kind of technologies that you have get widely used, not just in the developing world where it'll be invaluable, but also in the U.S.
In the U.S. as well, and especially in primary care, where very few students are choosing to go into primary care, it's really important to be able to accelerate the educational process. And there are a number of schools in the U.S. who are now experimenting specifically in the primary care area with a three-year rather than four-year medical education program. And if you do that, you've got to figure out how to augment and accelerate that training, how to give students a lot broader exposure to cases that they may not see in their clerkships.
Well, I want to congratulate you on the work you're doing and the success that you're having, and I look forward to seeing your technology all over the place. Thank you very much.
Thank you.